Hello, I'm Scott Durrell, and welcome to another episode of Power Platform Unpacked. In this episode, and indeed in the next few episodes, we're going to be talking about the Power Apps Component Framework, or PCF. It's a topic really close to my heart, but in this episode, we're going to be asking the question, do you really need a PCF control? So before we start answering that question, let's ask ourselves, what problem are we trying to solve? It's really easy to dive straight in. PCF is one of those things that is new tech. It's really exciting. I've been building custom UI extensions on top of Dynamics 365 and the Power Platform for model-driven apps for a long time, and I had an open source framework called Sparkle XRM, which aimed to bring together a lot of the libraries that at the time were the kind of the de facto, so jQuery and Knockout.js, and in an attempt to make it easier for you to build custom UI components. The problem is that when you start a HTML web resource, you were really just starting from a blank page. And then PCF comes along. And the cool thing about PCF is that it's not just a framework that allows us to extend model-driven apps and canvas apps. It's actually the framework that Microsoft used themselves to build components for the first-party apps. So what we're seeing now is a lot of the components inside Dynamics 365 apps are using PCF. So we've had the editable gridding in model-driven apps for a long time, and that's a PCF. So what we're seeing is it's being opened up to us. So it's new tech, really exciting. I've been there myself. So you jump in, you start using that tech, and think, hey, I could use it for this particular part of my application. And you spend some time, hours turn to like days, weeks. And before you know it, you're so deep committed into building that particular component. It's really hard to kind of backtrack and start to ask yourself the question of what problem am I trying to solve? Because if you do ask yourself that question, and the answer is, well, the problem I'm trying to solve is that somebody didn't like the out-of-the-box control for a lookup, for example. You know, maybe someone said, you know, I don't like the way it works. I'd rather it did it this way. Unfortunately, that's not really going to be a very good reason to build your own PCF control, because the thing is that the more time you spend on a component, and this is like a universal rule, the more time you spend on building something, the more costly it's going to be to maintain it. And certainly things like upgrades are going to be a pain anyway. So the answer to the question, what problem are you solving, has to be about end user value, real concrete value. Another common theme I've seen is where someone will say, well, okay, I need to build in some kind of custom validation or something like that inside a control, and or some kind of filtering in a lookup. And again, it's very easy to just jump in, because PCF is the newest piece of tech. Surely it's the solution to all of our problems. Well, a lot of the time, actually, just using a plain old JavaScript web resource in a model-driven app is actually going to be the better option. So I'd urge you to see how far you can get using the out-of-the-box controls. And only then, when you've got a concrete answer to what problem am I trying to solve, and you can then trace that down to the benefit that it's going to give you and your users, and therefore the value, you can then start to offset that, the benefit and that value, against how long it's going to take you to build it. Because these things are not simple to build. I mean, they're not easy things. They're not hugely complicated, but it's compared to dragging some controls onto a form using the out-of-the-box stuff, we're sort of talking, you know, orders of magnitude difference. So the approach I tend to take is, how far can I get with the out-of-the-box stuff? Can I get like 80% of the way, 90% of the way of my application? Indeed, can I get 100% of the way using the out-of-the-box controls, but in certain places a bit awkward to use my application? You know, you might have a data grid where you have to open up each record and perform an action, when it would be so much easier to do it in bulk in one place, you know, with some sort of hover control, or you know the kind of thing that you see in sort of custom web applications. And it's very easy just to sort of jump into customizing things, because let's face it, everyone's got very high expectations of the user experience these days. I mean, we're living in like consumer app generation where everyone's got something on their phone. You know, the phone is like, there's an app for everything, and I can just go in and that app is a very dedicated, and the user interface is specific to what I'm trying to do. So, you know, in contrast, where you've got a model-driven app, then the user interface is always going to be kind of generic because it's about trying to make it very quick to create a particular interface. So using that model-driven app, how far can you get? Now, obviously with Canvas apps, you've got a lot more flexibility. You know, you are almost in the realms of creating such a tailored UI. But then again, there is going to be places where you think, it'd be nice if I had some sort of drag and drop thing there or a different kind of visualization. But nevertheless, push those boundaries, see how far you can get. Can you get 100% of the way? And then what you're going to find is that because you've learned a lot from that experience, because you've actually got 100% of the way or maybe 90% of the way in building that app, you're going to have a lot better understanding of how your users are going to use the app. And then you can start to come back to that key question of what problem are you trying to solve? Because then the problem is going to be it takes too long to do a particular action. It takes like 100 clicks when that's just not practical. Or someone is going to be doing it with one hand because they've got another hand operating a piece of machinery, or they need another hand to operate another terminal or something like that. So, you know, in those circumstances, then you can specifically lock it in to a particular problem. So now that we know that we've got a problem we're solving, the next question to ask is, do we really need a PCF control? Because let's say we're building a model-driven app. What we can do is we can embed Canvas apps inside model-driven apps. And as I said, the Canvas apps, and as you'll have learned in previous episodes in this series, the Canvas apps, you can just do anything you like. There's a blank surface. So you can use your imagination, make a very tailored user interface. And because now what we can do is we can combine those Canvas apps inside model-driven apps, then actually that starts to unlock a whole load of scenarios that really you would have never been able to do if you were just building model-driven apps. And what I'm seeing is a lot of people are still kind of stuck in that old model-driven way. They're stuck in those days of, well, okay, I've got a form and I've got a grids and views and a ribbon button and how far we can get. And oh, if you can't solve it using that, then we're going to go to PCF, or back then it would be in custom HTML web resources. But now we've got this whole new opportunity in terms of embedded Canvas apps. And yeah, there are some challenges with embedded Canvas apps. And again, we've covered those already in some of the previous videos, you know, separate session and responsivity is quite hard to do, can be done, but it's quite hard to make it look exactly like the native user interface inside your model-driven app. But nevertheless, it's certainly a huge time saver and in terms of maintenance, etc. So now, if you're still absolutely sure that you need a PCF control, the next thing to decide on is, well, how much of this functionality needs to be a PCF control? And actually, how much functionality probably needs to be somewhere else, like server-side logic? Because again, it's very easy to jump in and build a whole massive application that's entirely inside your, like, using JavaScript, TypeScript, etc., and inside a really rich UI. But one of the things about the Power Platform is that it's very ethos. In its very nature, it's designed to be extensible. So if you go ahead and create this really rather complicated PCF control, someone's going to come along and want to extend it. And they want to potentially want to build their own Canvas app or maybe their own custom form. And they may even bypass your PCF control entirely. So you need to decide on, well, what rules really cannot be broken. And to a certain extent, these kind of things were the same when you were building HTML web resources. But because PCF controls are sort of designed to fit much more natively inside Power Apps, that this extensibility story really holds true. Because what someone could do is they could customize the form and they could change the control that you're using to render a particular field. Or they could swap it out for some of the other out-of-the-box functionality. So decide on how much logic needs to be in the client side and how much logic needs to be on the server. And that will then start to give you an insight into actually where is the PCF functionality really going to lie? Where is that sweet spot of the value that you can provide? Sometimes, of course, you may have logic that's duplicated in multiple places. You might decide, you know what, there's going to be logic that has to happen, validation perhaps on the client, but then that validation is always going to happen on the server because it's absolutely a rule that cannot be broken. Very tempting just to implement it on the client. But if you really think about the ethos of the extensibility of the platform, and if it's an important rule, then make sure that you put at least some degree of protection to prevent somebody extending the rule, extending the form, or extending, creating their own custom app, creating records and completely breaking the whole data model. So back to the question, what problem are we trying to solve? As well as the total cost of ownership kind of category that we've just talked about, there is another dimension to this, and that is the problem in model-driven apps or canvas apps? Now, I've talked about primarily model-driven apps at the moment. So we talked about, you know, extending model-driven apps using HTML web resources, and now we can go and do that using PCF. But back in February 2020, there's a preview of in using PCF controls inside Canvas, because originally PCF controls kind of were very much tied into model-driven apps. And indeed, their entire history of PCF has come from model-driven apps. As I said, the out-of-the-box editable grid is a PCF control, and that's been around for many years, I think. You know, I can't remember exactly when it was, but it feels like years. And so what happened was, is I think the team were looking at this model-driven apps, canvas apps. We got PCF, we can extend model-driven apps, but we've got these canvas components and canvas apps, which were, you know, low-code components, but there's no extensibility model. And Microsoft are always talking about no cliffs, unless your name's Cliff, but that's a different story. But the thing is that with model-driven apps, no cliffs, because if we need to extend the UI, we can with PCF. With Canvas, okay, we've got Canvas components, but that's still going to have a cliff. We can't implement some functionality. The classic example was, if you ever tried to display multiple items on a map in Canvas apps, you'll know that it's a real pain and it's very difficult to do. But what we're seeing now is, in preview, there is a map control, which is actually a PCF control that allows you to show multiple pins on a map. And so previously we had these two very different extensibility stories for Canvas and model. But now what we're talking about, the Microsoft team are talking about, is this unified control mechanism, which is the PCF. And so it's still in preview. It's not out of preview yet. And potentially things are going to change. But what we can do now is we can now write PCF components that will be usable inside Canvas apps. Now, I've been doing some really cool stuff with this recently, and like, you know, using creating like calendar views, which is very difficult using standard Canvas app stuff. But it's very easy to assume that just because it's the Power Apps component framework, it's very easy to assume that just because it's a single framework, that it's the same writing controls for model-driven and Canvas. And that literally is not so. This may change in the future, obviously put the caveat, but at this point in time, and certainly in the immediate future, it is very different writing controls inside model compared to Canvas. There's a very different runtime. And I think that's what you need to understand here is that although it's the same framework, the framework is providing data to the control, and it's providing a host that the control can render inside. The actual context that that control sits in is what's very different. Inside a model-driven app, if you're on a form, you're going to get a form context. So you're going to get the whole save, the auto save, the navigating away. If you're in a data grid, you're going to have a view selector and you can change. You can have inline charts and having the ribbon, the command bar operating on selected items. None of that exists in Canvas apps. You know, so in Canvas apps, it's literally just a custom visual of data that you give it. And so what we're seeing is in Canvas apps is a much purer environment. It doesn't have really any opinions other than just the inputs, the outputs, and the data sets that you're providing. So at this stage, when you're asking yourself, what problem are you trying to solve? If you like just saying, well, you know what, I'm just going to create a cool control that does some cool stuff. Well, you do need to think about, is it going to be in model or is it going to be in canvas? Because the types of problems that you will need to solve are very different depending on those two different runtime hosts. So that's all for today. We covered a lot of questions there. I appreciate that. But I think sometimes taking a step back when you're planning something, if you're doing a proof of concept, if you're embarking on a new project, take a step back and ask yourself these questions so that you really truly are making the right decisions. And sometimes the answers are not always going to be jump in and start coding. I tell you what, for me, that's the answer. When the answer is start coding, that's when the fun starts. But sometimes it could be a lot more expensive than you expect it to be. If you do want to learn more about the PCF, specifically in model-driven apps, if you head over to learn.develop1.net, I have a course that's just been recently released on building professional PCF controls for model-driven apps. And you'll learn the whole kind of life cycle, all the way from like the basics, more advanced topics, some of the secrets that I use for building my own controls, all the way into Azure DevOps. So if you're interested, check it out. But until next time, take care. Cheers.